So we're set for what should be an absolute belter. Not the final anyone expected. Sasser and Xinhua, ranked third and fourth going into the playoff stage. Only 3 points separated these two teams when they met in the regular season. Xinhua coming out on top by 3 points on that occasion, 74 to 71. The question's got to be, how much did that big win for Sasser against the Hornets, stopping the Hornets in the march for their three-peat take out of them as we enter the final minute before tip-off. As for Xinhua, they came through against Siglap relatively comfortably in the end. Siglap, though, ran the Hornets close, so the form line suggests there's not much between them. Current form lines, at any rate. It's going to be fascinating to see as our crew get ready. It's Wong Chu Liat, our crew chief, Desmond Paul and Neo Kok Eng will back him up. The referee's in charge. Xinhua and Sasser get ready for action. Head coach, you've done such a good job with Xinhua this season, Hang Li Jin. And what about the job Kui Chai Lim did in guiding Sasser to that masterstroke? Remember that final play where the Hornets tried to win it on the buzzer? Was it arrogance? Or was it just a brilliance of the defence of Sasser that brought it home? Well, there's a question for earlier in the week. Now it's all about these two teams. Xinhua in the maroon with yellow trim and Sasser in the white with gold letters. Four quarters of 10 minutes to crown the National Basketball League Division 1 champions, live on the 11 Sports Facebook page and the Sports SG YouTube channel. And as ever, a big number 30 racing up for the tip-off. Delvin Goh had that great battle with Russell Lowe in the semi-finals, and he's made a great start to the final. Delvin Goh winning the tip-off. So he assassin the first choice at points, and they went for a big three to kick things off with Qinghuan Tou. No good though. And look how quick they are in transition. Xinhua for going for three of their own. They get a second chance at a three, will they? Have to move it around the arc. The hustle is good in defense from Sasser, just as it was all the way through that game against the Hornets. Oh, the layup no good for the first points. Delvin Goh thought he had the defensive rebound, but it comes off the rim. And it'll be a second straight possession for Xinhua. But the pass from Phung Kok Chan drifting out of bounds. And now driving forward for Sasser. Chen Quang Zhou. 2-point jumper. Oh, in and out. Great offensive rebound though. He's everywhere already. Chen Quang Zhou. 3-point attempt. No good. From Poli Hao. But the first points of the final are on the board. And they go to Sasser and Chen Quang Zhou. So Sasser into an early lead. Just the 2 points so far in this one. Xinhua trying to fight straight back. Inside it goes. 2-point jumper. Misses by a long way from Kenneth Lowe. Great opportunity as well to give our most valued sponsors a name check. Shot zone. 2XU and leaning. Sasser stretch the lead to four early on. First 2 points of the final for Delvin Goh, who if Sasser on to win it, you'd be pretty surprised if it isn't turned out to be the MVP. Chen Yi. Poor Sasha. Oh, lost in flight there from Ching Pang Tao. They still get it back though, under pressure. 2-point attempt no good from Chen Yi. And Xinhua, looks like they're going to try and be really quick in transition here to try and counter this threat. Is a three going to be their first scoring play? No good from Kok Fong Chen. Oh, and this is on a plate for the layup. It's a 6-0 lead. Po Wei Hao makes it 6-0. And Xinhua coach Han Li Jin is sitting off. First time out called with just 2:27 gone in the first. A packed house here at the National Basketball Centre of Singapore for this men's Division 1 final. The winner of this will have bragging rights for 12 months. They can call themselves the best club basketball team in Singapore. And SAFSA have made the kind of start that suggests they're determined it will be them. If you are just joining us, you've missed the Hillcrest Greys going through the Women's Basketball League season undefeated and ultimately rather convincingly getting the victory against Quanxi, coming out on top of that one. 64-37. So a big gap between the best two women's teams in Singapore in the final. And an early start that suggests SAFSA have got the edge over Xinhua, but very early stages. We saw ebbs and flows in both the semi-finals. Big attempt, nothing that met. It's only 2 points though. Seemed like it should deserve more from Mitchell Folkoff. But that only counts as two. But Xinhua off the mark. Will SAFSA reopen a 6-point gap on this possession? Gets it out to Delvin Goh. Delvin Goh with the fade and the fake. Out for the 3-point try off the rim from Poe Hau. Oh, and that was good hustle. Offensive hustle from Ping Pan To. But it's Xinhua ball. Mitchell Folkoff, nice fade, pass inside. 2-point jumper. Missed by a mile from Kenneth Lowe. Here's the Delvin man, Delvin Goh. With an easy two. Delvin Goh, 4 points already. Glad to see the pass man enter the fray. He's standing by to come into the action. Mitchell Folkoff dancing round just inside the arc. Driving into the paint, 2-point jumper off the boards, no good. But picking up his own rebound was Edmund Ming. Massive three for Mitchell Folkoff. Oh my word! Folkoff with a giant three from fully 3 yards outside the arc. And Xinhua closed the gap to three. Calvin Goh called for the travel. And now the Pac-Man into play for Xinhua. Qingpo Yap also on the court. Mitchell Folkoff in possession now. Monster three right on the buzzer to bring Xinhua back to within three. They trail by as many as six. Mitchell Folkoff for another two. Just misses Delvin Goh. Who else with the big defensive rebound? 5:26 to play in the first. SAFSA by three. Delvin Goh loitering with intent here, but do they need him? The answer is no! Big 2-point jumper from Chen Yi. Chen Yi's first points of the night. SAFSA out to a 5-point lead again. Pac-Man, quick ball. 2-point jumper, no good. Coming up short, Qingpo Yap. And straight up the other end comes SAFSA. Oh, Mitchell Folkoff with the steal. The Pac-Man looking for it in the paint. Do they need him? Oh, the foul is drawn. Delvin Goh rejected.
gasps from the auditorium. Delvin Goh called for his first foul of the night. He's already got 4 points on the board. He's the first man to be called for a personal. Mitchell Fulkoff coming up with all 5 of Xinhua's points. That monster 3. That's one for the highlight reel at the end of this one. Up to the line for the first 3 throws of this final. It's Christian Panero. Nails the first one. Panero to close it to within a 1-possession game. No problem at all. Perfect 2-from-2 start from the line for Xinhua. They're going to need to keep that going as they want to keep pace with Sasa,
who themselves are onto an electric start. Delvin Goh and Pathman. There's a big matchup. Coming round on the overlap. Into the paint. Ah, good play. Tubon Jamba. No good. Ping Huan To just coming short. And Mitchell Fulkoff from one end of the court to the other with a layoff for 2. My word.
Chinpo Yap took a battering with that one.
But scoring with that one was Ko Fong Chang.
And it's a 1-point game.
They trail by 6. They now trail by 1. A turnover here and a score in the next possession. And that'll be a big swing inside this first quarter. Good hustle. I think Delvin Goh will be credited with that one.
Lead back out to 3. Mitchell Fulkoff. Fulkoff into the paint. No good, but the Pathman is there. His offensive rebound, though, not converted.
And there's space on the quick transition. And Sasa are in once more. First points for Zhonghang Wang.
Pathman, 2-point jumper.
No good. Pathman's shooting form as it was in midweek. Not at its usual electric best. And that's the easiest of layups. Pung Chat Lim. It's a 5-point lead once more in the flash of an eye.
It's almost as if Sasfa felt affronted that Xinhua had got to within 1. And now they've opened up to a 7-point lead with 6 unanswered points. Xinhua finally gets something going back of their own, but they still trail by 5 inside the final 3 of the first quarter.
Oh, great strength, great strength, great hustle from Delvin Goh. And he somehow manages to keep possession with his Sapsa team. So Sapsa avoided that Xinhua storm and are now intent on opening out to a 7 or maybe even 8-point lead. Delvin Goh controlling the court as always. Oh, they've caught that one up though. Mitchell Fulkoff picks up the scraps. And Xinhua with 2.5
to go in the first quarter, looking to finish strong. 2-point jumper is a good 2-point jumper.
Strong shooting from Chinpo Yap.
The 3-point, 1-possession game once more.
Delvin Goh, 2-point jumper. Oh, in and out.
Can't get much closer than that. Don Ng getting ready to play.
Timeout was called there, but you see the timeout ball went up, but nothing doing. They're close to within 1, Xinhua. Remember, they trail by as many as 6. Delvin Goh looking to re-establish a 3-point lead. Does well to draw the foul on Pathman. Timeout finally called.
This time by Sasa. So, an enthralling start. 1:44 left in the first. Sasa led by as many as 6. Xinhua close to within 1 now, twice inside the quarter having trailed by that many. And every indication we're going to be in for a close finish here
at the Singapore National Basketball Centre in this grand final of the National Basketball League Division 1 between Xinhua and Sasa. In the presence of Mr. Lim Tek-yin, Chief Executive Officer of Sports SG, and in front of a packed house here. Not a spare seat to be had as you watch us live on the 11 Sports Facebook page and the Sports SG YouTube channel. Another chance to mention our sponsors, Shot Zone, 2XU and Li Ning, done so much to bring basketball to the fine level it's found now in Singapore. As head coach Lim Kwee Chai
gets ready to send out SAFSA for this final minute 44. Of a quarter that they've dominated to all intents and purposes, but only so far coming out of with a single point lead. But stepping up to the line to extend that, he'll hope by two is Delvin Goh.
Remember, so far Shin Wah perfect two from two from the line. What will happen for SAFSA's first foray to free throw territory? And they also go one for one. And Delvin Goh, as you'd expect, goes 2-4-2.
Not much room to work with here. Jin Hua, they did well to fashion the shot, but it's no good from Jin Sheng Tok. And now,
a chance for SAFSA to make it a two possession game once more. Delvin Goh asks for the ball, and when he asks for the ball, he genuinely gets it. Being pressured, hassled and harried by Christian Pinedo. Oh, big three, no good. Delvin Goh with the offensive rebound now, and Delvin Goh, another 3-point attempt, is good. Huge three at the end of the first. Coming up with a big play there, Ramus Low. And the 6-point margin is opened up once more.
Acres of space for Pinero, no good. And SAFSA come up with a defensive rebound.
It's Ramus Low who just nailed that monster three. Not a bigger monster, is the one that Mitchell Folkoff came up with earlier in this quarter. Inside the final 30 seconds. Should be at least a possession each to come from here. Delvin Goh, another 3-point try. This one falls short from Song Han Wong,
and straight up from coast to coast, for the attempt of coast to coast, was Jan Sheng Tok. Instead he draws the foul.
Foul drawn on Ramus Low. So Jan Sheng Tok to go to the line to keep up their 100% record from it, and they need both of these, trading by six, 11.7 seconds left in the first quarter.
Good as gold with the first one. Cuts the gap to five. There's 11.7 seconds left in this, so SAFSA will have some time to score again in this quarter, especially now that the second one's been landed. So the gap down to four. 11.7 seconds for SAFSA to go from one end of the court to the other and finish this first quarter with a flurry.
Delvin Goh. Maybe Delvin Goh will go himself here. Five, four, three. Would you believe it? They turned it over. A chance for a flurry for Jin Hua, right at the death as turn expires. John Ung with a steal and a layup. And all of a sudden, just like that, at the end of the first, it's a 2-point game. SAFSA 21, Jin Hua 19. Stay with us. Second quarter on the way. So both
sets of players back on court well before the allocated couple of minutes to gather their thoughts at the end of the first quarter. Chinua will be much the happier how that first quarter ended, even though they still trail by two with less than a minute to go in that quarter. They trail by six. A big 4-0 run from them,
concluding with that fine steal and layup from John Ung.
And it's John Ung again, this to tie it up. 2-point jumper.
No good from Kenneth Lowe.
And Delvin goes trickery. See Sasa come up with it.
Well, nearly fumbled that, but instead, the smart play and layup from Seonghan Wong.
And Sasa are back up into a 4-point lead. Two-pointer off the rim and out.
Defensive rebound from Remus Lowe.
He's had a very busy start to this one.
Big three-pointer, rebounds galore as well.
Three! No good from Remus Lowe on that occasion.
A couple of changes. Mitchell Falkoff coming back into the fray. Pathman as well. Mitchell Falkoff, the driving force from one end of the court to the other at the moment for Chinua. They still trail by four.
You can see Kendi Lee about to come on.
Not able to make anything happen on that possession, Chinua. So it's up to Sasa again. Oh, thought about the huge three. Instead they go inside. Look for a jumper. There is a two-point jumper. And it is good.
Solid two-point jumper from Chen Yi. And having closed it within one possession at the end of the first quarter, Chinua find themselves trailing by six once more. 8:17 to go in the second. Mitchell Falkoff, been a magician. This will count for two if it drops, which it doesn't. From Chin Po Yap. And this is where Chinua have got to be careful that Sasa don't get away from them. 6 points is as big as the lead's been throughout this match so far. Until now, big two from Chen Yi opens it up to eight.
Chinua must look to score in this possession. They can ill afford this lead to get away from them to double digits. Mitchell Falkoff, that pass took a deflection, but still coming into the paint and drawing the foul for Chinua is Chan Kok Fong. Has taken a seat, Christian Pinero, with Kendi Lee coming in.
Mitchell Falkoff to restart. They trail by eight. Need some points to take back from this visit to Sasa territory. 2-point jumper from Falkoff is no good, but they come up with a rebound and it finally drops. Smart play from Chin Po Yap. Keep Chinua in touch, but they've given up that 2 points straight back with Remus Lowe's quick thinking. All that hard work undone in a flash with Remus Lowe finding a pathway to be found under the basket for the most easiest of layups. Mitchell Falkoff. Falkoff driving in. Falkoff, oh, great touch. Great work on the rebound, though. Huge play from Kendi Lee.
He's only just been introduced and he's made his mark already.
Get back to six.
In favour of Sasa. 6:47 left in this first half. Suggestion and hint of a travel there. Matters not for Sasa. Seonghan Wong.
His effort comes to naught. And Chinua go for a big three.
Got the impression when Kok Fong Cheng let go of that, he wasn't entirely convinced, and they come away empty-handed. Meanwhile, Delvin Goh with the freedom of the court to do what he likes with here. Sets up for the three. No good from Chen Quang Chou on that occasion.
Oh, good pass. And Delvin Goat draws another foul. And Delvin goes on two fouls already. He's game leading with 8 points. He's also game leading with two fouls. And with 6:07 left in the second quarter, Xinhua step up to the line to keep up the game's 100% record from the line so far, and a 4-from-4 record from Xinhua to try and close this to a 4-point game. First one is good. They're just hanging in there, Xinhua. Every time Saps look like they're going to go on the march and build up a double-digit lead, Xinhua come up with something special. And again, 4-from-4 from the free throw line. How important might that prove to be at the end of the game? Now, Safsa. Well, then go. Ah, it's a monster. A big, big three from Ramos Lowe. Coughed it up there. Xinhua trailing by 7. Travel. Travel is the call on Boon Quat Lim. Big defense. Crowd goes up from Safa here. They stopped them on the previous possession. Can they stop them on this one? Pac-Man. With Edmund Goh waiting in the wings alongside Jiang Shengkok, the irrepressible Mitchell Fulkoff. Oh, it's going to be Saps the ball. Here come the changes. Halfway through the second quarter, Sapsa, who led by 1 at the end of the first, now lead by 7. But it was the second half of that first quarter where Xinhua came on strong. Can they do it again here? A stop here would be nice to start the comeback. Sasa have never trailed in this game so far. Delvin Goh misses with the layup. Comes back to try and get a second bite at the cherry. Pac-Man in attendance. But Delvin Goh draws the shooting foul on Pac-Man. And Goh will go to the line with a chance to extend the lead to 9 once more. Four from four from the line, Safsa. That's the first free throw miss of the game, that. Delvin Goh taking his time with his second attempt. And the second one misses as well. And Mitchell Fulkoff comes up with the rebound. So the first missed free throws come one after the other. Courtesy of the hand of Delvin Goh, and the gap remains at 7. Mitchell Fulkoff, a score now, would be a big momentum shift. They will keep possession. As in for Xinhua. Comes Kelvin Yeo. Change of basketball. I'm sure that might be a Delvin Goh's request after missing those two free throws. Mitchell Fulkoff taking a well-earned rest. He's worked his socks off so far on that monster three. I'm not sure we'll see one from a greater range than that in the remainder of the night. Pac-Man, plenty of space for the two-point jumper. And Pac-Man comes up with his first points of the evening. And the gap down to 5. 4:22 now to go in the second quarter. Ah, oh, great drive. Deserved better luck than that in the lane. Junrong Ting looking for his first points of the game, and that was so close to a 3-point play opportunity. Drawing the foul, Xinhua once again finish a quarter strong with Jiang Shengtok. Nonetheless, he'll go to the line with a chance for 2. This to close it to within 3 points. And the foul's also backing up for Safsa now. They're up to 3 in this first half. Oh, not a good time to miss the first. Xinhua free throw. They were perfect 4 from 4 prior to that. 4 from 5 now, make that 5 from 6. The gap is 4 points inside the final 4 minutes of the second quarter.
Who's going to get this precious halftime lead? Safsa for 3. No good that time from Weihai Po. And what about that for the speedy transition? And that's got the crowd going. Kieran Leo.
First point of the night from Kelvin Leo.
And what pace he showed there, the small man. Darting into the lane with a simple layup. The gap is now just 2. Shot clock down to 3 here. They've got to get one away. And they do. Right on the buzzer. Big score that from Safsa. Look how quick this is. Delvin Go picks that one off. It was Boonkiat Lim that came up with that marvellous buzzer beating 2. The jumper good. Gap is 4. Inside the final 3 minutes now. Looking for Delvin Go. Pac-Man will be in attendance. Delvin Go driving into the lane. Can he get the better of Pac-Man? Out for the 3. Off the rim. And here's a chance for the quick Chinua break to close to within 2. Pac-Man with a layup. And it's good. Pac-Man's finding some form. And Chinua trail by 2. They've trailed by as many as 9, remember. In 2 quarters. Could have been a tale of 2 half quarters. Safsa always starting strong. Jinwa always finishing strong. Disappointed with herself there is Kenneth Lowe that he gave up the foul in that situation.
Come on.
Coming into the play for Jinwa is Leon Cha. Possession on the sideline for Safsa. Chong Han Wong to restart. And so it goes to Remus Lowe. What a half Remus Lowe's had. And what a half Boonkiat Lim has had. That's back-to-back layups for him. Without them, this would be a tied game. Because Jinwa, every time they come forward, now they look like scoring. But they kicked them all away that time. And Safsa, every time Jinwa look like they're going to tie it up, Safsa come away and stretch out once more. A possession now to extend the lead. To potentially a 3 possession one, leading by 4. So the 2 minutes to go in this first half. Into the lane, drawing the foul, and they'll go to the line once more. Remember, Delvin Go missed both of his previous free throw attempts. Surely Lightning's not going to strike 3 and 4 times in a row. And another change of basketball, second change of ball we've had in the game. Must give a mention to our crew chiefs in attendance here, doing such fine work. The crew chief is Wong Kwee Liat, Desmond Paul and Miao Kok Eng. The officials taking charge of the National Basketball League Division 1 final. There you go, Delvin Go's got the radar back on. Now 1 from 3 go from the line. Stretches the lead out to 5. Normal service is due, nothing but net on that free throw attempt. And it's a 6-point lead once more, which on balance has probably been the average lead that Safsa have enjoyed in terms of the clock throughout this contest. But we saw in that final 2 minutes of the first quarter, Jinwa came on really strong. And they'll try and do the same again. And it's been the speed of their transition, particularly on turnovers, that's been a joy to behold. Richard Fulkov under some pressure. So it's more than that to get the ball off Fulkov though. Thinking about the 3-point try there. But instead, coming inside. Shot clock down to 8. Mitchell Fulcroft with a slight miscontrol. 5 now. 2-point jumper with 3 left. Hits the rim. And they somehow come up with it once more, Ginois. Superb hustle and offence. They had two goes at the defensive rebound there, South, so they couldn't get it done. And Ginois really are hanging tough here. Now 5 seconds once more on the clock into the lane. Oh, that's a thing of beauty. A thing of beauty from Leon Chia.
Leon Chia with his first couple of points.
Gap back to four. Good screen there. Give Delvin Go a chance for a jumper. Delvin Go thought about the three. Drawing the foul that will now put Sasa in bonus territory. So having drawn the foul, Quinn Quang Tog in theory has to do the easy part of making Ginois pay for it. 1:02 left in the second quarter. Delvin goes, two missed free throws on his previous but one trip to the line. The only free throws that have been missed in this game so far. Ching Huang To to re-establish a 6-point margin with 1:02 left in this first half. No, no good. So the gap remains at five. What can Ginois come up with here? Well, the ever industrious Leon Sharp is onto this like a flash, directing traffic. Mitchell Falkoff, does he fancy a dip at three, or will he just try and get in the paint? Well, he'll send it outside for a big 2-point jumper that misses by miles from Leon Chia. And Sasa are up for some quick transition of their own. Oh, diving into the lane, but coming up with a layup that was no good. Rishan Wong,
but never fear. The offensive rebound sees them open up a 7-point gap, Sasa. And it's an important last 27 seconds this. Ginois have to score. If they miss and let Sasa come up with more points, it'll be a big margin for them at the start of the second half to overcome. Big play this. They come up with it the second time, no good. And with 13 seconds to play, surely Sasa here will run the clock right down
and try and extend this 7-point lead into half-time. Delvin Go looks to get inside. 2-point jumper as time expires, misses. Well, it's no good from Ching Huang Tarp as the buzzer goes, but nonetheless, Sasa have led pretty much from gate to the halfway wire here. It's a 7-point lead for them. Delvin Go marshalling the troops brilliantly. He's the only player in double digits for the night so far. Ginois have really hung tough and they closed to within a couple of points on more than one occasion, but every time they did so, Sasa pulled out more. And at half time, it's Sasa leading Ginois by 7, 41-34.
I was broken from a young age, taking my soak into the masses, writing my poems for the few that look at me, took to me, shook at me. My message from the veins, speaking.
Go defensively as well. Oh, good rejection.
Third possession on the spin that Ping Pang Toe hasn't come up with something. Pathman's in some space if they can find him. Or will they need it? No, they won't. Here's a run from Xinhua. Kenny Lee.
Up to 6 points on the night. Closes the gap from 9-5. Two consecutive holdouts and two consecutive scoring possessions for Chinois. 2-point jumper.
Oh my word, doesn't get any closer than that from
Chen Yi. They get it back, and it's Chen Yi once more. Find support. In Delvingo. Delvingo out, big three this.
Off the rim, no good. Quing Quang Toe. Little bit off kilter with his shooting in the last minute. What a move! When it wasn't Mitchell Falkoff that got the points. They'll be credited to Chingpo yet, but it was Mitchell Falkoff's fading move. We've got the crowd oohing and aahing here, and all of a sudden, just like that, the gap's from 9-3.
Well, it's still a long way from happening, but one has to ask the question, what would Sasser be like if they had to end up coming from behind here? They've not had to come from behind at all in this game.
They had to come from behind against the Hornets, of course.
They managed to pull that one out the fire in spectacular and dramatic fashion. But Chinois, every time it looks like they're going to go behind by double digits, they come up with a run to hang tough
here. Credit for that must go to the coach, Hanley John,
who is refusing to let Sasser run away with this. ...7:38 left in the third. And such is the clamour to watch this game that there's no seating available for a large part of the spectators, hence we've got some of the younger spectators actually having to sit courtside. The referee and crew just getting them to fade back a little bit there. Speaking of fading back,
there's a big two. Back with his scoring boots on is Quing Quang Toe. Gap out to five. And this is what's happened to Chinois. Every time they've closed it up, Sasser go on a run of their own. Foul called on Wee Hao Po. Sasser.
This is first foul of the night. Pac-Man's in space. Mitchell Falkoff. He's the magic man for Chinois. 2-point jumper, nothing but net. That's a fine fade and a fine 2 points from Chingpo Yap.
And it's again a one possession game.
Can Chinois come up with a stop as the defense cry from their bench is demanding? 2-point jumper off the rim, Mitchell Falkoff, who else?
Comes up with a rebound, quick in transition, but losing it and somehow getting it back in for the two.
Mitchell Falkoff lets it run back into the half for some fresh seconds. Falkoff,
shot clock at 10. 3-point jumper to tie it up off the rim.
And that 3-point try, if it had gone from Kat Fong Chan, and it would have been a tied game for the first time since the very first second of action. Some 23 minutes, 45 seconds ago. The whistle had gone. I don't think that will count, will it? Are they going to give that? Well, it's the fourth foul on...
Fourth foul called on Kendi Lee.
So he's in foul trouble. The two is going to count, and there's a plus one to come. So a 3-point play in the offing from Chen Yi. If this one goes down, doesn't. Pac-Man comes up with it. So still five. But crucially, Sasser out again to a two-possession lead.
6 minutes now left in this third quarter. Mitchell Falkoff into the lane. Off it goes. Oh, it's a 2+1 on their own. Chinois, Kendi Lee, he may be in foul trouble himself, but he drew the foul that time, and he'll go to the line to close the gap to two.
Just awaiting confirmation, yes, those two do count.
So sinks this, and Chinois will get to within two. Remember, they trail by seven at half time. So already enjoying a 4-point swing. Oh, that's a bad miss from the line though. Plus one's missed from both Sasser
and Chinois in the last 60 seconds. Gelbin go, lots of space in front for Heat. Gelbin go looking to draw a foul there instead. The foul and possession goes the way of Chinois.
Merle, would you like to name the winner now? They've never led Chinois. Trailed 6-0 early, trailed by as many as 9. They've never trailed by double digits though. Oh, and that would have tied it up. As it is, Delvin go. Oh, loose pass. Latched onto by Chan Shang Tok.
They couldn't make that turnover count though. It's a very stop-start game at the moment, and that appears to be suiting Safsa just that little bit more. Certainly the scoring pace has slowed down in the last couple of minutes as John Ung gets ready to come back into action. Delvin go, backing up, Delvin go under the basket. Tries to reverse layup, doesn't happen. Mitchell Fulkoff showing great strength. And Mitchell Fulkoff draws the foul. Chinois, if they can fashion a three here as John Ung comes into play, we'll have a tie ball game for the first time since that first tip-off. Over 25 minutes of basketball ago. No timeouts called by either coach in this third quarter so far. It's a suggestion that they're, for the most part, liking what they're seeing. Certainly there's been nothing wrong with the defence in this third quarter. Oh, three-point try in the offing, is it? No. Hustle. Pinero! Two-point jumper, no good. Great rebound work from Chimpo Yap. But the second attempt, no good either. And this time, Delvin Goh comes up with a rebound of a defensive kind. Defense from Kenneth Lowe. Possession though. Sticks with Safsa. On comes the quick-footed Zhen Quangzhou. Also Kelvin Liu in the mix. Oh. Well, that was a bit too relaxed from Safsa. It's going to come out to Kelvin Lowe off the rim. Not sure whether that would have been a three or a two. The signal never came up. All of a sudden getting a bit frantic now inside the final 4 minutes of the third quarter. Still Safsa by three. We're scoreless over the last minute. Who's going to get what could be a crucial next score? Safsa in white, Chinois in the maroon, and Chinois come up with a steal, and just like that from end to end. Oh, he's got the layup. Kelvin Liu botched the layup that would have made it a one-point game. Well, talk about the scoring slowing down. But a very quiet third quarter from both sides. Chinois just edging this quarter. They need it by four, but they still trail the match by three. And travel called on Safsa. Pinero gets us back on the way. Fulkoff not on court at the moment. They'll be looking forward to his return, the Chinois fans. That would have tied it up. The three no good from John Ung. Now driving into the lane and passing it off to Pinero. The layup no good. Safsa just slowing it down now inside the 3 minute mark in this third quarter. managed to draw a foul there. Saf's up. First foul on Kelvin Leo, whose botched layup would have made this a 1-point game two possessions ago. He had a score now for nearly 2 minutes and still nothing goes down.
But something might go down now. Pinero up the lane. Layup no good. Chen Quangzhou. Delvin Goh.
Delvin Goh's up to 12 points. And he'll go to the line to try and get two more. That two doesn't count, but he will go to the line for two free throws. First foul called on John Ng. Delvin Goh, who missed two of his four free throw attempts in the first half of this game at the other end of the field. Can he be one for one at the start of his efforts at this end? Will he certainly go one for one? Makes it a two possession game once more. They have one more attempt and they've got some height in there as well, should he miss, Sasa, to come up with this if it hits the rim. And miss he does, but Sasa won't come up with it. Wu Chan Lim unable to get there. It's grabbed by Kenneth Rowe. Up into the lane for two, first one on the way! Chan Cheng Top! Under the attention of a foul, he gets the two, there's one to follow. And now a chance to really tighten things up once more. To make it a 1-point game with 2:26 left in this third quarter. Both teams in bonus territory in terms of foul counts. And it's a 1-point game! Zhang Sheng Top doing the work. And Sasa have seen enough. Timeout call by Lim Kwee Chai. They led by 7 at half time. They only lead by 1 now with 2:26 to go in the third. So, a stop here for Xinhua, and they have a possession to lead for the very first time in this game. They've already had a 6-point swing at the start of the second half. Well, that's a three from nowhere! Where did that come from for Sasa? Pointless for so long. Chen Quangzhou. And the lead by four once more. What a huge three that is in the context of the game. And again, every time Xinhua gets it within striking distance, Sasa pulls something out the fire. And that missed three attempt from John Ong is going to give Sasa a chance to open up that magic number. Six seems to be their magic number. They've led by that digit for large portions of this game, but they won't lead by it. And this time, John Ong with a chance to atone. He doesn't, but he does draw the foul. Remember, both teams will be going to the line. Foul bother for all. That foul is going to be called on Ramus Lowe. He's going to have to start to be careful as well. Three fouls for Lowe on the night. Reminder, stuck on four fouls is Kendi Lee. First one, no bother at all from John Ong. Again, the gap is three. Talk about tense. A fitting final this, the National Basketball League of Singapore Division 1 showpiece. And it's a 2-point game, 51-49 Sasa lead. They've led
from the gate, but can they lead to the wire? Still 11 minutes, 37 seconds to go in this one. A minute 35 left now in this third quarter. Melvin Goh, he's stuck on 13 points for a while. Certainly not been as prolific in this quarter as he was in the previous two. Oh, somehow they managed to keep possession. Another three on the way, is it? Oh! It's a monster! Qing Huang To with a big three. And again, Safs are put away. Xinhua will have to ask themselves what they need to do. Well, they need to win more plays like that. Lovely layup. Beautiful play, Kelvin Liao. And again, it's a one possession game. What a finish to this third quarter. They're going to set the fourth up nicely. Particularly if Xinhua come up with another stop here.
Right. Name it slow. Seven on the shot clock here. Knocked out by Jono, who's had a strong end to this third quarter. Shot clock's on play here. Now down to six. Ramos low for three. Nothing doing. Who's coming out with the rebound? Oh, my word. The biggest physical mismatch available on the court.
And it happened there. Delvin Goh against Kelvin Liao.
Goh called for his third foul of the contest. And now, two free throws for the small in stature but big in heart, Kelvin Liao,
to make this a one-point game with just 38.6 seconds left in the third. You get the feeling, don't you, folks? This is going to go all the way live on the 11 Sports Facebook page and the Sports SG YouTube channel in association with our magnificent sponsors. First one isn't any good. Our sponsors, Sock Zone, 2XU and Leaning. And the sponsors and our guest of honour, Mr. Lim Chek Ying, the Chief Executive Officer of Sports SG, enjoying this final. Well, Xinhua fans would have enjoyed it a lot more if Kelvin Liao had sunk those two free throws, as it is. With 29 seconds to go, it's still Sasser by three.
Kelvin Goh's not scored for a while. Oh, foul is called on Sasser.
24 is the man that it's been called on. Qing Huang To came up with a monster three a while back, but now he's coughed up the foul that's going to send Xinhua back to the line with another chance to close the gap. And look at this. It's the diminutive Kelvin Liao, who just missed two in a row. I mean, he scored those two. He'd be going to the line now with a chance to give his side the lead. As it is, these two can get them to within one. He's not going to miss three in a row, is he? He is, you know. Well, the self-doubt starting to creep in. His teammates trying to encourage him. Surely he's got to nail one of these four at least. Would you believe it? He misses all of them, but two of the Safsa boys in each other's way will cover up position straight away. Timeout going to be called. Good time to call timeout by Hanley Jun. And with 18.7 seconds left in the game, it's a fresh clock and possession for Xinhua. A three could tie this at three-quarter time. So, what has Xinhua coach Han Li Jun concocted here? He's been busy on the play board. Not seen much of Mitchell Folkoff in this third quarter. I'm sure he's being kept back for a big fourth quarter run. Delvin Goh, as always, is constantly on the court. poor free throws. Kevin Liao has to get a pass right, and he does. Just about stays in the court, and I mean only just. John Ung, 12 seconds left on the quarter clock and the shot clock. John Ung driving it all the way for two! What a strong play by John Ung! This is a one-point game! And it will be a one-point game with just 0.4 seconds left in the third quarter. It's going to be a one-point game, this. Going into quarter number four. So, Jinhua, 12 by 7 at halftime. They've made up 6 in the third quarter. And Sasa lead by just 1. Have Jinhua timed their run to perfection? Or will Sasa come on strong again in the fourth quarter? We're just 10 minutes of hoops away from finding out who will be crowned the National Basketball League, Division 1 champions for 2017. Stay with us live on the 11 Sports Facebook page and the Sports SG YouTube channel. Worth remembering here that Jinhua, 12 by 1, they've never led in this game. At the start of the fourth quarter, they've never led. They went into a 6-0 deficit early, 12 by as many as 9, but try as they might, Sasa couldn't open up the double-digit lead that would surely have stood a chance of killing them off, and they're now in possession to take the lead for the first time. Psychologically, this could be massive. Oh, they tossed it straight to Galvin Goh. And again, every time Jinhua get within striking distance, it's Sasa who pull away once more. Going to be a very tense finish, this. The defensive pattern is good. The two-point jumper is a mile away from Po Wei Hau. And again, well, this is the first time Jinhua have had two consecutive chances to take the lead. Can they make this one count? That could be telling. One of their form players in possession. And here's another one of their form players, John Ung. To Len Yong, to John Ung. He's furious with himself, John Ung. And again, they spurn the chance to take the lead for the first time. Just to go through the scoring charts, not one player from Jinhua in double digits. They've spread the scoring load. Sasa relying largely on Galvin Goh, and of course, Kling Kwang Toe has come up with like a couple of massive plays. They've fallen short on that occasion, though. Third chance for Jinhua to lead for the first time. John Ung! It's a Jinhua lead by one! And it's John Ung who almost single-handedly has dragged him kicking and screaming into the lead. 8 points on the night for John Ung. And Sasa 12 for the first time on the night with only 8:30 to play. Galvin Goh need a play from him, they get a play from him, Sasa regain. Galvin Goh now up to 15 on the night, Sasa by one. John Ung, I should say, Edmund Goh on that occasion, falling short. So, having trailed for the first time, is that the wake-up call that Sasa needed to put something together? I can see Mitchell Folcross about to re-enter. The Magic Man can try and make things happen, but he'll be doing things with his tide at this point, trailing by one. Maybe not for long. Jonung again. Oh, miscontrol. Back into the paint. Oh, it's a straight pass. But here come the big guns. Mitchell Folkoff's in. Chingpo Yap is in. And I'd be surprised if Mitchell Folkoff's not geared up now to play the final 77 minutes, 42 seconds all the way through. Both teams, teams with timeouts up their hands. In their hands, I should say. Or up their sleeve, take your pick. But Sasa crucially with the lead. It's now 3 points. Superb hustle under the basket from Seonghang Wong. And Sasa open up once more. What can Mitchell Folkoff do? He entered with his team trailing by a point. His first contribution is to just miss with that two-point jumper attempt. And again, as they've done all through the game, admittedly, the first time in this quarter, they trailed every time Tsinghua strike near them. Sasa have pulled away. Delving go. Waiting. Delving go. Lays it off. Solid defense. Great play from Kenneth Lowe. Out of bounds. Mitchell Folkoff furious. 6:38 to play. Sasa by three. They led by seven at the half. They led by one at three-quarter time, and they trailed by one in this quarter. But a 4-0 run has sent them back to a three-point lead. Delving go, inside, outside, delving go, hustling. Sets up the three-point try. No good. And they will come up with possession. Thought for a minute Mitchell Folkoff is going to lose out in the rebound stakes there, but they do come away with it. But after enduring a 4-0 run, Mitchell Folkoff will know as he drives from one end of the court to the other the importance they score here. Really strong zonal defence this from Sasa, but it couldn't stop that layup. Beautiful finish from Chingpo Yap. He's into double digits on the night. 10 points. The first player from Tsinghua to register double figures. Oh, lovely play to Delving Go. Oh, thought for a minute Go was going to draw 2+1 as it is. Sasa star man will go to the line to try and open up another 3-point gap. The Pathman back in the house. Pathman comes in as Kenneth Lowe takes a rest. Come on. 5:37 to play. First one from Go Good. Opens up the gap to two. You watch live on the 11 Sports Facebook page and the Sports SG YouTube channel in association with our friends Shot Zone, 2XU and Li Ning. Delving go, only one from two on those two tries, so a 2-point play here from Tsinghua, and we'll have a tied ball game, and it's been a long while since we've had one of those. Again, not been tied since the tip-off, and it's not going to be tied in this possession either. Oh, the aggression being shown by both sides, desperate to lift this National Basketball League Division 1 crown is there for all to see. But with Sasa getting the stop on Tsinghua there, they'll have possession, looking to open up a lead of more than one possession for the first time in the fourth quarter. Oh, great hustle into the paint. He goes, moves one way then the other, but the layup no good. Seonghang Wong denied, and at the other end, not to be denied. It's Leon Cha. It's tied at 59 with five to play in the fourth.
go. Plenty of time for the two-point jumper that doesn't drop. And Mitchell Falkov comes up with it. And here's the Puffman for a lead. Well, where's the Puffman's form come from? He's up to 8 points for the night. And Jumois lead by two. And that's their biggest lead of the night so far. Wowee, Jumois. Finding some form, Delvin go with that rare two-point jumper miss under no pressure whatsoever. Other than the context of the game, there wasn't any defense near him. And Jumois, who looked for large parts of this game that they were going to fall away, they hang on, they hang tough. Trailed by seven, as many as nine. And now they lead by two. And Safsa, who've largely relied on the 16 points of Delvingo and the 10 points of Qing Huang To, now needs some of the others around him to step up. Bit of team effort without any shadow of a doubt from Jumois, outside of the 10 points contributed by Ching Po Yap. Nine other players have chipped in, including three with 8 points, one with seven. Say three with 8 points, four with 8 points, and one with seven. And it's that team ethic that saw them past Siglap in the semi-final. It's that team ethic that at the moment has got them nosing in front for the narrowest of margins against the Safsa team that, remember, were clutch at the death to see off the Hornets in the semi-final. Oh, they've coughed that up. Have Safsa. So 24 seconds on the clock for Jumois to open up by four or even five. Mitchell Falkov wants this. He's not going to get it though, because a two-point jumper is good from Ching Po Yap. And what does Safsa do now? They trail by four. Defense, defense, defense,
defense, defense,
defense. Oh, Mitchell Falkov so very nearly coming up with a steal. As it is, he disrupts the momentum for Safsa. They're really struggling on offense all of a sudden. Huge possession this. If Safsa don't come up with some points, and Jumois get a stop, which they almost do. And now they definitely do. And Mitchell Falkov, of all people, driving into the paint to make it a 6 point game. Oh my word. Well, the basket will stand, but it was scored with a Safsa man prone on the deck. So this break is given without having to call a timeout. Hanley Jun a chance to relay a message to Kok Fong Chan. Just need to get a visual on who that player is for my commentary vantage point. Oh, that's terrible news for Safsa. Remus Lowe, who has been a focal point of their team throughout the competition, he is in some pain there. His return has got to be listed as doubtful with only 3:52 to play. Meanwhile, it's a 6 point Jinhua lead. Remember, they didn't lead till the fourth quarter. And boy, the Safsa need Delvin Go to come up with some plays now. And Delvin Go does come up with a play now. He gets the two, or goes to the line for the plus one. With a chance to close the gap to three. The Pathman straight back in. Every free throw precious at this stage of proceedings. Delvin Go up to 18 points. He's the only player on the court that's got a squeaker getting to 20 in this one. But he's still two away from it. He misses the plus one. It's still a two-possession game. And what's more, Jumois in possession with Falkov. Oh, I thought for a minute he was going to panic. Ching Po Yap shows what I know. Pathman, the experienced Singaporean international, calming things down. Pathman wants this. He's in space. Oh, no. Lane violation. So Safsa breathe a sigh of relief, but they need to score now in every possession, really.
3:27, still a long time in basketball, but if this gets away from them to a three-possession game, I don't think there's any way back, you know. Delvingo drawing another foul. Quizzical looks from both Mitchell Folkoff and from Kek Fong Chan about that decision. But it will send Delvingo to the line. He missed that last free throw for the 2+1. Now he's got another two free throws that will take him to 20 points on the night. And far more importantly, I'm sure for him, Saffron's up to 63, trailing just by two. But he's missed another. Well, it's his four free throws tonight, Delvingo. Usually so reliable, if he'd have scored all of them, Sasa would now be levered as it is. They'll trail by four. And this one has to go, surely. Oh, he's missed another. Well, Delvingo missed five free throws. Mitchell Folkoff with a chance to extend the Xinhua lead even further. And we're almost into the final 3 minutes. Folkoff dances his way in the lane with a two. Mitchell Folkoff into double digits on the night. And Xinhua lead by six. Well, it seems a long time ago now that Mitchell Folkoff came out with that monstrous three in the first quarter when Xinhua were needing all their resources to hang in here. And now he comes up with a clutch layup just as Delvingo's skills seem to be deserting him. The star of the SAFSA show in the semi-final win over the Hornets is now struggling to find form with 2:49 left in the fourth quarter of the final and his team trailing by six. Oh, hanging jump. It's right on the edge of the court, Parker. Instructions out here. Has he masterminded the come-from-behind success story of the season so far? A three here and it might be game over. Off the rim, no good. But they come up with a rebound. And they get possession back. Mitchell Folkoff heads it off under a lot of pressure, but he still scores. Leon Cha is an 8-point lead of SAFSA. Raise the white flag here. Xinhua didn't lead till a quarter of the way through the fourth. They trail by seven at halftime, as many as nine throughout the match. But galvanised by Mitchell Folkoff, the game leader. Well, I say game leader, he's 11 points and the 12 from Chang Po Yap. Looked like steering Xinhua to a national title. Oh. They wanted a call there, they didn't get it. Didn't matter, the three was a fresh air shot. And Mitchell Folkoff now to make the lead 10. Oh, on. Leon Xiao again. Played in by Mitchell Folkoff, gets the two, he'll have plus one, and this would be for an 11 point lead, and that, ladies and gentlemen, with 1:54 to play, would be game over. What a turnaround this is. Xinhua, the fourth quarter performance of the season, in the biggest game of the season, the National Basketball League Division 1 final. Sensational scenes here, and it goes. I see no way back for SAFSA now. They call a timeout, but how on earth is Lim Kwee Cha going to galvanise a team that led by nine and who now trail by 11? And Delvingo cuts a long figure on the court as his magic touch deserts him at the worst possible time. Deep in the stretch when they need the clutch, it wasn't there. And Xinhua pulling away here. Mr. Lim Chek Yin, the Chief Executive Officer of Sports SG, is standing by to present the trophies after the game. Of course, one final chance to thank our esteemed sponsors, Shot Zone, 2XU and Lee Ning, who've worked so hard to develop basketball in this great nation of Singapore. It's a sport that's consistently growing year on year, and that wouldn't be possible without the sponsors. And of course, this great new initiative of carrying the finals live on the 11 Sports Facebook page and of course on the Sports SG YouTube channel. If you're watching us there, You are very welcome. And you're watching the last minute 54 now of a final that for large parts of the first three quarters, Jumois looked like they had not a hope in hell of winning, but they've turned on the start in the fourth. And galvanised by some magical play from Mitchell Fulkoff and some heavy scoring from Chingpo Yap.
They are 1:54 away from being crowned the National Basketball League champions.
And what about the effort from the coach as well? Hanley John remained calm all the way through the three quarters when they trailed. And he's still a picture of calm now, although I'm sure inside, if he takes the seat for the first time tonight, he's doing cartwheels. Again, Safsa come away with nothing. And that's it. That's game, set, match as Delvin Go
draws the foul. And that'll be his fourth of the match.
Right, they're just playing out time now. Oh, look at that from Fulkoff. Now you better believe he's the team leader for Jumois. They lead by 13, this is incredible. And the three's no good. And the rebound's no good. And Fulkoff, who else comes up with a defensive play inside the final minute? And now Safsa, their title dream collapsing around them, are just resorting to committing fouls out of desperation to stop this fourth quarter juggernaut that has been Jumois. And Mitchell Fulkoff, the star of this show, he might not be the game leader in points, that's Delvin Go with 30, but he's the MVP of this match without any shadow of a doubt. Less than a minute to play here at the National Basketball Centre of Singapore. Oh, well, that's going to be a technical called on. Personal foul, rather, called on the 31, the 12-point scoring Chingpo Yap. Delvin Go, I've got to say, is cutting a really dejected figure. Got the battle of Russell Lowe and the Hornets in midweek. And now they've come up well short against Jumois, having done the hard work of beating the defending champions. Oh, this is getting nasty, this game now, towards the end. There's some unnecessary fouling going on. Not much malice in it. I say nasty, that's a bit unfair. There's no tempest being frayed, but I think just frustration from Safsa and desperation from Jumois to get through the final 55 seconds so they can be crowned champions. Pathman's going to go to the line, though, to extend this lead even further. Well, not Pathman, I do apologise. It's going to be Chingpo Yap. Maybe that was some payback for the foul he committed earlier on. First one doesn't go down. Not that it matters, leading by 13 with 55 seconds to play. A reminder, they trailed by 9 at one stage. They trailed by 7. On a couple of occasions, Safsa looked like they were going to stretch out to a double-digit lead, but they couldn't. Jumois, they huffed and they puffed, and they finally did blow the Safsa house down in this fourth quarter. What a display. Just making sure that we don't see any more monkey business in Chingpo Yap and Wee Han Po. Still carrying on. Wai Ho Po involved once more. This has got to stop, hasn't it? Both of them getting a bit niggly, but no question, the man with a smile on the face is Chingpo Yap. His 12 points have contributed a huge portion of the 74 that have come from Jumois. And in the personal duel with Mitchell Fulkoff, the MVP for me in this game, he goes to the line with two more to overtake Fulkoff in the point scoring stakes. Well, my word, Safsa have been reduced to ashes in this fourth quarter. The defense collapsed, the offense disappeared. And that two from Yap Chingpo means it's 15 points the differential now with 53 seconds to go And if anyone had said to me at half-time when they trail by seven that with under a minute to go they'd lead by 15, I wouldn't have believed them, but it's happened here. And they cannot buy a basket in this fourth quarter, Safsa. My word. What a time to have your worst quarter, and I'm sure this is Safsa's worst quarter of the whole competition. Their basketball season fading at just the wrong time. Mitchell Fulkoff. Delvin Goh with a cursory grab of the hand. It matters not that that one misses. And this could well be the final possession of the season. The National Basketball League Division 1 champions are going to be Xinhua. They've beaten Safsa here by 76-61. They trail by 7.5. As many as 9 was the difference at one point. But a sensational fourth quarter run sees them win it by 15. Mitchell Fulkoff, for me, the MVP. He finishes with 13 points, one fewer than the team leader of Yao Qingping. And even the 18 points of Delvin Goh were not enough for Safsa, who fell at the final hurdle, but nevertheless deserve credit for finishing as runners-up. But the winners of the 2017 National Basketball League Division 1 crown are Xinhua Sports Club. On behalf of everyone at 11 Sports and Sports SG, from the National Basketball Centre of Singapore, it's congratulations to Xinhua and of course our ladies champions as well from earlier on today. Well done to Hillcrest Greys. We'll see you next year.
For the Women National Basketball League Final, Commander Charge CSE, Andrew, Chelsea, Hillcrest Green. For the NBL Division 1, Sigurd Basketball Cup, SBDHK Hornets, Southside, and of course Singapore Sigma Sports Club. This cutting is then moving top 2 to play card.
Okay, looks like we're almost there for the prize ceremony here, live on the Sports SG YouTube channel and of course the 11 Sports Facebook page. It's the prize ceremony for the Women's National Basketball League and the National Basketball League for Men Division 1 titles for 2017 in the presence of the guest of honour, Mr. Liam Tek-Yin, the Chief Executive Officer of Sports SG. Stand by, the presentation ceremony coming up momentarily. We've got a master of ceremonies that will guide you through the 4, 3, 2 and 1 placings of all the teams that are in action live today on this great day-long basketball event.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's our honor to invite our guest of honor, Mr. Liam Tek-Yin, CEO of Sports Edge, for the prize presentation. Mr. Liam Tek-Yin. Thank you. Congratulations and congratulations to SC. In third position, we have Edgeon, Singapore Cerebral Culture. Congratulations, of course, presenting to you Women's National Basketball League champion, Hillcrest Gray.
Yeah.
Congratulations to the basketball club. In third position, named by SPPHK Hornets.
Xinhua celebrate their well-deserved success. Congratulations too to the Hillcrest Greys, all of the 8 teams that competed on this finals day, and all the basketball players across Singapore who contributed to a great basketball season in the Lion City State. But we'll leave you with pictures of Xinhua celebrating their come-from-behind stunning victory in the final of the National Basketball League Men's Division 1 Championship here live at the Singapore Basketball Centre. Thank you to all our sponsors, Shop Zone, 2XU, and of course, Ling Na. We should look forward to seeing you next year live on the 11 Sports Facebook page and the Sports SG YouTube channel. towards Singapore National League Basketball. For everyone here, good night.
Our NBL Division.